I'm going to do an experiment on dehydration. So for me to try out an experiment on dehydration, I have some materials that I'm going to use. I have a funnel. Then I have the burette. Then this is the grab scanner. I also have the pipette. So this is the pipette, and this red thing is the pipette pump. I also have the conical flux. Then I have two solutions that I'm going to use. I have the base and the acid. I also have the indicator. So I'll start my experiment. The first step that I'm going to start with, I'm going to add 25 mL of the base into the conical flux. So how I'm going to do it, I'm going to get my base, then I'll get my pipette. So using my pipette, I'm going to measure 25 mL of the base. So I'll just correct up to the neck region, which means I have corrected 25 mL of the base. Then I'll place it into the conical flux. So I have just added 25 mL of the base into the conical flux. Then my next step, I'm going to add 3 drops of the indicator. In this case, the indicator that I'm going to use is bromothymol blue. So I'm going to add 3 drops of bromothymol blue into the conical flux. Then the next step, I'm going to fill the burette with the acid. So I need to fill the burette up to the zero mark. So how you do it, you just fill the burette above the zero mark. After you've done that, then you put your beaker here, then you open your tap, then you get the zero mark. That's how you make your burette to be zero. So I'm just going to fill it above the zero mark. Then I'll zero my burette. Then now I need to zero up my burette. So I'll just open the tap. So immediately it is zero across the tap. So I have zero again. Then the next step, I'll put my conical flux in. Then when you put your conical flux in, you use one hand to open the tap, then the other hand to shake the conical flux. So in this case, I'll use my right hand to open the tap, then I'll use my left hand to shake the conical flux. So make sure you just open the tap slowly. So I'll start. So immediately I'll see the first color change across the tap. When the first color change appears, this means that all the acid that has been added to the base has reacted completely with the base. So I have my color here, and the solution here has turned to yellow. And the yellow point indicates the end point. So here I'm going to get the the volume of the acid that has just reacted with the base. Here my volume on the buret is 17.5. So for this experiment, I've known that 17.5 mu's of the acid that was in the buret has reacted with 25 mu's of the base that was in the complex. That's all about this experiment. Thank you very much.